Cisco multi-platform phones, MPP, are IP phones that have a user-friendly screen that makes it easy to set up and adjust the phone's settings. It is referred to as a web configuration page, web user interface, or graphical user interface, GUI. You can log in as an administrator on the GUI to easily configure features, all through your favorite web browser. It ensures that your phone is tailored to meet your specific needs. In short, it's a user-friendly way to set up and manage your phone settings. In this episode of Cisco Tech Talk, I'll show you how to access the GUI of a Cisco MPP IP phone. Next. To start, the phone needs to have power and connectivity to the network. If you already have connectivity, you can skip to the next section of the video. To get connectivity, you will need an Ethernet cable. Connect one end to the Ethernet port on the back of the phone. It is labeled with an icon of three connected computers. If you have a power over Ethernet, PoE, capable switch, connect one end of the Ethernet cable to one of the PoE ports on your switch. This is the most convenient way, as this single connection is all you need. This port can transfer both data and power simultaneously. If you do not have a PoE-enabled switch, you can still plug the cable into a switch, but you will also need a power adapter to power the phone. Connect the power cord to the power port. If you do not have a switch, you can connect the other end of the Ethernet cable to an Ethernet outlet on the wall or to your router. Optionally, you can connect the PC port to your computer to access the network through the phone. You should have a DHCP server automatically assigning IP addresses. This server will assign an IP address to the phone. It will be in the voice VLAN it is assigned to, if applicable. This is most often configured on the router or switch. After these steps are completed, make sure you are not connected to a VPN, as this might prevent you from accessing the phone on your local network. Now you need to know the IP address that was assigned to the phone. One way to find this is through the phone's MAC address, which can be found on the backside of the phone. In this example, I'm using a router as the DHCP server. In the GUI of the router, check Status and Statistics under DHCP to see the IP address assigned to the phone based on its MAC address. Another way to find the IP address of the phone is by navigating through a few different menu screens on the phone itself. This can vary depending on the model of the phone, but the general steps are the following. Click Settings. Navigate down to Status and select it. Click on Network Status, then IPv4 Status. On that screen, the IP address will be listed. Click the link in the description if you need more details on this process. Once you have the IP address, you can verify the IP reachability by pinging the IP address identified for the phone. Open a web browser. Type the IP address of the phone in the address bar and press Enter. By default, it will redirect to HTTPS. Access has been granted. When it opens, it will display the phone's model number, IP address, connection type, DHCP, MAC address, and software version. To get things set up for future logins, navigate to Admin Login and then Advanced. Under the Voice tab, there is an option called Display Password Warning. If this is set to No, there will be no pop-up indicating that a password is not configured. If you enable this option and save the changes, a notification will appear on the screen indicating that no password is provided. Navigate to the Voice tab and then System. You will now see an option to change the password, allowing you to set an admin password and a user password. Sometimes, you may receive a security warning while accessing the phone GUI using a browser. In such cases, accept the security warning to bypass it, and access the IP phone. There you have it, the basics for accessing the GUI of a Cisco MPP IP phone. Now you can set and customize settings and features to best suit the needs of your business. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.